I kind of
like. Oh, I liked it like that.
Kind of bluesy vibe.
I just like that song. You could turn that into a mustache Canadian fellow song real quick. Leon Redbone. You can make
Have you ever seen Leon Redbone live?
No, I have not.
Yeah, I have.
I'd love
back
to.
In the 70s. I've seen a few amazing one-man shows, and he's one of them. John McEwen also does one amazing one-man show, and John Hartford did an amazing one-man show. Of course,
Steam Powered Airplane,
Bean Blossom, right?
I said John Hartford. I saw a number of times. Of course, he was a Missouri guy, up around. I'm from Missouri, so he did a lot of shows up there. John McEwen was a Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. Really, if you think about it, there was another progressive bluegrass band.
Yeah.
You just never put them in that category because they...
There was no category.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, they also had that Jerry Jeff song with the Miserable Jangles.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Play that one.
Sing it, see, but it's not.
Waltz, right?
Let's see, I
think. I've learned it before.
But. Yeah, I don't play it on the banjo normally. I'm just fooling with it.
The dance, jazz dance version that Jerry Jeffen recorded.
Well, I've heard him
yeah,
do
a version. I've heard with this
steel player. Was just, oh, I don't know if it's the same version, but Lord.
I'm not ready to.
Okay.
I'd have to do it. I'd have to do it on a guitar to start with, just to show you the chords.
Here.
I do it in C normally. But here's guitar. Then I don't have the words. I don't have them right. Memorized. I always worked off of music art. I did it enough where I almost had the words memorized for a while, but it's a wordy song. Wordy songs don't. But something else is crossing my mind. I'm trying to nail it down. I'm trying to pick up that earlier thread of something I had the cojones to pull it off, whatever it was. Songs that have like two chord changes, like that old Joe Clark.
Yeah. Darlin Cory?
Yeah.
And G? Or we'll
yeah.
Pick G.
No, I don't care what key.
Well, I mean, whatever. Yeah, I don't care either.
Yeah, well. You're singing.
Okay.
So
well, I do it in A in the band, but we could do it in A.
You played in the band?
Yeah. Yeah, he's just slumming here.
I mean, is A a good?
No, A's fine.
Oh, okay.
I
don't know.
I'll
I
put
like
my capo on.
I like the. Oh, okay.
With the song, I don't think I know.
Dig a hole. Dig a hole. Dig a hole in the cocoa. It's just like one chord, but you said we could add a G to that. We could add a D to that.
Or, yeah, just add what you want to. Or I don't mind if it's just one chord.
The version I learned is from the Flat and Scruggs version, which is, I'm going to butcher it, of course. But if you want to sing on it.
Well, I think you have license because Flat and Scruggs butchered the version.
Dig a hole, dig a hole, dig a hole.
song, and then I got bitched out for ending the song. I'm like, what the fuck? He started giving me like, and so I ended the song with the band, you know, I took it in like, doom, 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 and the band, and it was great. And then later on, I was like, hey man, I was trying to tell y'all to keep going. You remember that part we did in practice? What's this number then? Yeah.
That's good.
That's and good. The show for autistic adults that I got yelled at. Thank you.
your ass.
Yeah.